Rose, who was gone yesterday? Ethan, you were gone. Did you get the notes?
Scott was gone.
And who else was gone yesterday? Did you get notes?
Scott was gone.
Did you get notes?
Yeah, it's right here.
So you're good on that?
Yeah.
Okay. Hey, would somebody remind me what the assignment was again? I'll put it up here on the board. It was
page 348,
3 through 10, 13, 16,
13.
You said 3 through 10?
Yeah, then
13,
and
16,
through
19. Okay, so if you were gone yesterday, get that down. I think I had originally said you Friday. Push that off to Monday. Okay. Make sure you're not due tomorrow, but due for Monday. Is that okay? So change that. If you haven't made that change, make sure you make the change. Do Monday. And then on your notes yesterday, I said we're going to refer to a page in our book with some of this stuff. I think it was page that you need to refer to was. Was it 669? Okay. So you're going to want your books open to that page right away, too.
Yeah.
candid. Is that better? This was the hypotenuse. So if you ever hear me talk about things that are opposite, oh shoot, I got a problem. Hang on a second. Okay. So that's kind of where we were at, all right? And then guys, trig ratios, you're gonna hear me talk about trig ratios today. Two trig ratios we're really gonna talk about are gonna be what and what? Sine and, that's the way it's written on your calculator, sin, but it's sine. You might think I'm sinning by giving you this information. All right, okay, I guess that wasn't funny. And then this COS stands for what, guys? Cosine. Those are the two trig ratios we're really going to talk an awful lot about, okay? The two things that if you can really remember right off the bat today, gang, if you can remember, hey, if you can remember these two things right here, sine, its definition. What's the definition of sine again? Opposite leg over the, and what's the definition of cosine again? Adjacent leg over the hypotenuse, all right? And then two trig ratios we're really going to talk about are going to be sine and cosine. Okay, let's take a look at the second page. Guys, what I need you to do at the top of this right here is go ahead and sketch yourself a right triangle right here. I'm going to drop my right angle in right here. I'm going to call this triangle, I'll put Y up here, Z down here, and we'll put an X down here. Okay, and I'm going to put some distances in this thing, okay? I'm going to put some distances in this thing. I'm going to tell you this distance right here is 15. I'll tell you this is 36 down here. And I'm going to tell you this distance up here is 39. So go ahead and take a second and draw that triangle in that section. And we'll start talking about what the sine and cosine stuff means here. Who needs more time drawing that? Anybody? Okay. Guys, right here, it says write the following ratios. Now, keep in mind, ratios are simply fractions, aren't they? Ratios are simply fractions, right? That's what we started the chapter out talking about, was ratios and how they relate to fractions, didn't we? Okay. So write the following ratios. Well, this is pretty easy to do. What are we asked to find right here, guys?
Sine
of what?
Y.
When I say sine of Y, where does that tell me I'm standing?
At Y.
It says you're standing right here. This is where we are, right here, right? So we're standing right there, okay? Which two sides are my legs? 15 and 36. Which side is the hypotenuse?
39.
Okay. If I want the sine of angle Y, or the sine ratio, if you will, up here of angle Y, what's the definition of sine again? What's it stand? Opposite leg length over the. Okay, I'm pointing at angle Y right here. Okay, you said these were the two legs. In reference to angle Y, where you're standing, which leg is opposite, or in other words, not touching the 36? This is the opposite leg to that angle right there, isn't it? What's the hypotenuse? 39. So how are you going to write that ratio for the sine of Y? Well, you'd simply say the sine of Y is equal to the opposite leg length, which is 36, over the hypotenuse, which is
39.
Now, I want to do something real quickly, because this is where stuff kind of ties into your page on 669. How do you turn a ratio into a decimal? Just divide it, don't you? So couldn't I simply go 36 divided by 39? Take a look at your chart on page 669. Don't you guys have a lot of decimals right there?
Yeah.
Ton of decimals, okay? Guys, this is why stuff is important right here. I know that this angle is 90 degrees, but I don't know these angles. All I know is the sides. And the way that they come up with some of this stuff is to figure this out by putting all these values in like this. Guys, which ratio, which trig ratio did we just solve for?
Sine.
Okay. To help you read that chart on page 669, here's what I want you to do. Is everybody on 669?
No.
Okay, jump into the sine column.
Okay. Jump into the sign column. Are you there? Okay. I want you to follow that sign column down until you get to this decimal of about 0.9230. Does it go that far?
0.9004.939.
Is there a 0.92 in there?
Nope.
Yeah. Okay, it goes down. It goes down in that first half, but then you got to carry over into the second half, put on that sine column to about 0.92. Does that give you an angle equivalency to about 0.92?
Yeah.
What do you guys have for an angle there about?
67
degrees. Are we all at that point? Is it say 0.9205? Is that what it says in your book?
Yeah.
And it correlates to 67 degrees in everybody's book. Does everybody see that?
Yeah.
If you can't find it in your book, help your table partner find that, okay? So this is about how many degrees here? So what are these ratios really allowing us to figure out, guys? Some kind of an angle here, aren't they? Okay. So do you understand, first of all, how to read that chart as it would relate to what we had up here? Okay. Where does this 0.9230 come from, guys? Yeah, and so what I'm going to choose to do is right behind this, I'm going to write down that this is the same as a decimal of, what do we say, 0.9230? So once I turn that into a decimal, can I use that chart to figure out unknown angles now? Once I turn that into a decimal, can I figure that out?
Yes.
Okay, question?
Did you take 36
Yeah, 36 divided by? Because that was the ratio for the sine, and we're standing on y, right? Okay, and the definition of a sine function is an opposite leg, right? One not touching. So if I'm up here at angle y, isn't that the leg that's opposite of that angle right there? Okay, and then the hypotenuse would be 39. Okay, well, let's look at the next one, kiddos. Check this out. Cosine of angle y. Let's see, what's the definition of cosine again?
Adjacent
leg. Okay, so again, I'm looking for the cosine of y, right? Looking for the cosine of y. Everybody agree?
Yeah.
So where am I standing? Where are you at on this? Are you standing on X, Y, or Z? You're standing on what? Y. You're here. Okay. What's the definition of cosine again here, kiddos? An adjacent leg. What's the adjacent leg length going to be? 15. How about my hypotenuse? 39, huh? So what are you going to have for the cosine of y? Not 39 over 15. Hypotenuse will go on the bottom. So what over what?
15 over
39. Very good. Okay. How are you going to turn that into a decimal?
Divide.
You're going to divide, right? Okay. 15 divided by 39. What you got? What you got as a decimal? 15 divided by 39. What you got? 0.3846 about?
Yeah.
Okay. Would you guys be shocked if I told you that 0.3846 is going to be pretty close to 23 degrees? Go on your chart. What column am I going to jump into this time?
Cosine.
Jump into your cosine column. Go down to about 0.38 and tell me that's pretty darn close to 23 degrees.
Yeah.
Am I right or am I wrong? So it's pretty close to 23 degrees, though, right? So 0.38 or 0.37, somewhere in there. Is that, are you guys agreeing with that? Now again, which column are you in this time? You're in the cosine column, right?
It'd be like 68.
Oh.
Yeah.
68 degrees? 68? What did we say that angle was the last time? Ah, I was trying to trick you. Don't let me trick you. What angle was I talking about up here? What angle was I talking about in the first example? What's it say?
Y.
What was I talking about here?
Y.
Weren't we talking about the same angle each time? Wouldn't it stand to reason that in that triangle the angle's got to stay the same?
Yeah.
Do we get angles that were about the same?
Yeah.
Okay. Make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, so don't let me try and trick you on that and say, hey, oh, it's got to be about 23 or something like that. No, we're staying at the same angle for each one, so the angle's got to stay the same, right? Okay.
Yeah.
Are we good with that?
Yeah.
All right. Definition of sine again. What over what?
Opposite
over hypotenuse. Okay? Might want to write this down. In each case, what's always in the bottom? What distance will always be in the bottom of those ratios? The hypotenuse. Here's how I remember this. Sine and cosine. Let's see alphabetically which comes first. C or S? This is how I remember it. So when I think, okay, I can't remember if the opposite leg goes with sine or cosine, here's how I remember it. I say C comes before S, just like A comes before O, adjacent before opposite. So cosine before sine in the dictionary, right? Adjacent before opposite in the dictionary. That's how I kind of remember it. So what's going to go in the bottom each time? What's going to go in the bottom each time? Okay. Guys, I'm kind of torn right here. You're going to need a calculator for this stuff right here, but I also want you to know that it says use a calculator. Right down here, you might want to jot this down, or page 669. If you have your book open, this will be gold. I'm going to put three things down here. I want you to find me the sine of 23 degrees. Let's do the cosine maybe of 30 degrees. And let's do the sine of 45 degrees. Okay. I don't care if you get them from your calculator or if you get them from the book. I just want to make sure you have a decimal. When I say calculate the decimal equivalency of something like this right here, this is going to be important for where we're going next. I want you to go four places. Okay? So right here, when I say use a calculator, go four places. Because in your book, doesn't it go four places? Aren't those decimals about four places long?
Yeah.
Okay, so go four places on this. Okay, let's see if we can't answer from the book first. Go to 23 degrees. Everybody at 23 degrees?
Yeah.
Okay, what's the sine decimal equivalency for 23 degrees?
1.907.
Point how much, Carrie?
3907.
3907, do you guys agree?
Yeah.
Okay, let me check this. 0.3907. Now, guys, some of your calculators are going to have the following things in them like this. If I type in 23 like this, do I have a sine button right here?
Yes.
Okay, so what should I get out of this? I'm going to get a long decimal, but my first four digits should be about what?
3907.
Is that what we're getting there?
Yeah.
Okay, you understand where those are coming from?
How do you know when to stop?
We're just going to go how many places right here, Izzy? Four places will be good enough for us. Four places will be very accurate, okay? Because we're into tenths, hundredths, thousands. We're going to the 10,000th place, so that's going to be really accurate for us, okay? Like 1/10,000th of an inch, that's probably thinner than the thickness of one of your hairs, okay? So we're pretty accurate with that. Hey, what do you guys get for cosine 30? Can I guess on the cosine 30?
Yes.
0.8660?
Yeah.
Boom!
Boom!
By the way, if anybody's listening to the video, that was not a bomb that just went off. That was me. Sorry. I had to put a disclaimer on that just to make sure that nobody did a freaking hurry here, okay? Sine of 45. Can I try this one?
Yeah.
0.7071?
Yeah.
Isn't that exciting? Are any of you sitting in your chairs thinking, why do you know that?
Yeah.
Because I was president of the nerd herd. Thanks. Yeah. Now again, do you understand how I'm using the chart to get these values?
Yeah.
Okay. Go to your angle measure and then figure out if you're doing a sine value or a cosine value. Does this make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So if I say something like this, what's the decimal equivalency in the next page? Because the next page is going to be what's most important to us. If I say something like, what's the decimal equivalency? How many places am I talking about here?
Four
places. Okay. Four places. All right. All right, let's jump into page 3 quickly. Any questions so far?
We're
not 37, okay? All right, kiddos, this page, very, very important, okay?
Wow.
Very, very important. Here's how I'm going to handle this. I'm going to make a T-chart, kind of like this. I want you to do the same thing. We're going to do an example for both. sine and cosine, all right? It says, use sine or cosine to solve the following triangle. Basically, what you're going to be looking for is an unknown length, all right? Looking for an unknown length. So I'm going to write this right down here. In other words, find the missing length, okay? We're going to do an example that uses sine. We're going to use a sine example. We're going to do one that says use the cosine example. Okay, so go ahead, set that up. All right. Let's start on the left side. Go ahead and draw yourself a right triangle here. Oh, yeah, it does look nice. Okay, we're going to start by drawing a right triangle there. Okay, first of all, kind of describe to me where the right angle is. And that triangle right here, where's the right angle? Bottom left corner. Okay. Now, here's how this works. There's a lot of stuff going on here. Don't lose sight of the fact that the stuff we've talked about the whole chapter is to write a ratio or have equivalent ratios that form a proportion. Don't lose sight of the fact that we're still talking about some proportions. Okay? I'm going to go ahead and tell you this right here. We're going to be using a sine function to solve this problem. Does that make sense to everybody? I'm going to call this angle down here 33 degrees. Okay, so go ahead and put an angle in there, 33 degrees. I'm going to tell you the distance across from this is the unknown length that I would like to find. I want to know what that distance is. And I'm also going to go ahead and tell you that the hypotenuse here is 26. Okay? So take a second, get that written down. And our job is to find the missing length in this. In other words, solve for x right here. How long is that side over there that's unknown? Okay. Guys, besides the right angle, what other angle do you know? 33 degrees. Okay, what I like to do is this. You never want to use a 90 degree angle. Okay? You're always going to use an acute angle. Acute meaning angles less than what?
90.
Okay? Is there a measure up here that we know angle-wise or degrees-wise that's less than 90?
Yeah.
What is it?
33.
Okay, so what that means is this. It means 33 degrees is that angle on the bottom right. So I always say, well, where's your reference at? You are where? This is where you're standing. That's the point you're at right there. When you hear me talk about what's your reference point or what's your reference angle, our reference angle is 33 degrees, which puts us down here in the bottom right corner. Clear on that?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, if I'm standing right there, let me ask you a couple questions. First of all, this distance x that we're trying to find, is that a leg or hypotenuse?
Leg.
It's a leg. Furthermore, what kind of leg? Opposite leg or adjacent leg?
Opposite.
It's an opposite leg. So I like to put OL down here. It's an opposite leg. Okay. Then, we also know another side up here. We know the distance up here to be 26. Is this a leg or the hypotenuse? It's a hypotenuse, right? Okay, couple questions. We are standing right here, right? Right?
Yeah.
Nice little bicycle tire. We know that standing right here at the 33 degree angle, we have an opposite leg that I'm looking for and the hypotenuse. Let's see. Which of my two trig ratios, sine or cosine, is going to involve opposite leg or hypotenuse? Sine does, right? Here's how this works to solve for x. First of all, I'm going to use which function here?
Sine.
And listen why I'm choosing sine. I'm going to say the sine because I'm standing here, we're looking for an opposite leg, and we know the hypotenuse. So the two, one of the two ratios that involves opposite leg and hypotenuse was on the first page. What involves the opposite leg in the hypotenuse? Well, what function? Does, right there, right? Okay? So on this third page here, let's look at what we've got to do. Guys, we're standing right here, right? If I'm standing right here, what do we know at this angle? Well, we know the angle measured. So the sine of how many degrees? 33 degrees. So I'm going to say sine of 33 degrees. Okay? Now put an equal sign like that. Okay? Well, guys, doesn't this sine of 33 degrees look like the last page? I said, give me the decimal for that. Remember that? Okay, don't go there yet. Okay? Sine of 33 degrees, by definition, then, would equal an opposite leg length over the hypotenuse, right? Sine of this angle has to equal the opposite leg length over the what? Hypotenuse, okay? So the sine of my reference angle is equal to my opposite leg. What is the opposite leg? Don't know. So what are we going to put up top, though, for the opposite leg? X, right? That's the opposite leg. What are you going to put in for the hypotenuse, kiddos? Okay. So let's see. Sine of why 33 degrees? That's where we're standing, right? We can never use a 90 degree angle. Choose an acute angle. Why X up top? It's the, which forces which trig ratio? Sine. Opposite leg over the hypotenuse is the definition of sine, so therefore the hypotenuse had to be what value down here? Okay, now this is where you get into your book. Okay, and I'm going to give you a shortcut to this. What angle are you going to go to? Listen to what I say. We're going to take that trig function, sine of 33 degrees, and we're going to replace it with a decimal equivalency to how many places?
Four.
We're going to replace that function with a decimal equivalency. So in your book, go to 33 degrees, jump into the sine column, and what is this going to get replaced with? 0.446. Just like this, right? Now, anytime you have a decimal equivalency and problems like this that are solving for an unknown side, put it over a 1. Because anything divided by the 1 is still the same, right? Okay, I replace this with its decimal equivalency. Do you understand that? What's it still equal to? Still equal to x over 26, right? Hey, don't we know how to solve those now?
Yeah.
Got a question, real quickly, before I even go any further with this. Which side will always be the longest side in any right triangle? The hypotenuse. What's the hypotenuse length up here this time? And my final answer better be more than 26 or less than 26? Better be less this time, right?
Yeah.
Why don't you cross, multiply, and divide? Tell me what you get. When you get answers for unknown sides, just go nearest 10th, one place after the decimal for me. I can punch it up too. I get 14.2-ish. Yes? No one's?
Yeah.
14.2? Stand the reason that 14.2 would be shorter than 26?
Yeah.
Why did I choose a sine function here quickly?
That's because it's the opposite leg.
Opposite leg to the reference. Right. Question?
I have a question.
See you later. Sing your heart out. Well, don't do that, dude. Just sing, okay? Why do they say sing your heart out? Because if you sing your heart out, you're going to die. Right? Right?
Yeah.
It's true.
Okay.
Kind of like they say, dance your butt off. I don't want to carry a lot of money. Right? Let's do an example that involves cosine. All right. Well, where'd my tools go?
You didn't just do he gone, did you?
He gone.
Like Ken Harrelson of the Chicago White Sox. Stand that man. He's the most biased announcer for any sports club I've ever met in my or heard in my life. And when I went up to the White Sox game this summer, I was in the Legends area, and he was like, turn me to that cabinet, and I was yelling at him.
Really?
Yeah, because the Twins won. I was like, hey, y'all. And he could hear me. It was funny.
Was he mad?
No, I'm sure he gets it from a lot of people. Okay, let's do one with the cosine example quickly. We gotta run. Somebody give me an acute angle. Let's go acute angle right here. 12 degrees?
Yeah.
Let's go more than 45. 56, good. Here's my right angle. I'm gonna call this leg right here, this leg distance right here, call it a 17. I'm gonna call this an X, okay? Where are you guys standing at?
56.
You're at 56. That's your angle less than 90 that you know, right? Got a question. Is 17 a leg or hypotenuse? What kind of leg?
Adjacent.
To this point right here, is this leg touching the angle or not touching it?
Touching it.
Touching it means
adjacent.
It's an adjacent leg. The distance X that we're trying to find is my what? Guys, the question would be then this. If you are standing right here, you're standing right here, and you're trying to find an unknown length, knowing the adjacent leg and looking for the hypotenuse, which function of the two will involve adjacent leg and hypotenuse? Sine or cosine?
Cosine.
Okay? So let's do this. We're going to say cosine, which is defined as the adjacent leg over the hypotenuse. Guys, cosine, what's your reference angle?
56
degrees, right? That's got to equal my adjacent leg length. Is that known or unknown?
Unknown.
We know the adjacent leg, don't we? What is it? 17 over the hypotenuse of what? Okay. Everybody follow me so far? Trying to get through here in the last 2 minutes of class. What am I going to do with that cosine of 56 now, guys?
Figure out
its decimal equivalency. And make sure you put that decimal over a 1. What you got, kiddos? In your books, 56 degrees cosine.
It's
5592, Lauren?
Yeah.
Okay, and what do I want to put that over?
1.
I want to ask this question before we cross multiply and divide. That trig function is replaced with 0.5592, right? That's equal to 17 over x. You guys told me my hypotenuse is always the longest side. The one length I knew up here was 17. Will my final answer be more than that or less than that? Better be more, because we're looking for the hypotenuse. That's got to be the longest side, right? So I'm going to go 17 times 1 here, guys. 17 times 1 is 17, right? Divide that by. And I get about 30.4.
I did too.
About 30.4. Okay, two things here. Do you understand? Hold up, don't be moving it too much yet. Do you understand when you use sine and cosine?
Yeah.
Sine when you have the opposite leg and the hypotenuse. Cosine when you have
adjacent leg
and hypotenuse. That's first. Secondly, this page that I've got up here over on the side of the board, I know I gave it to you yesterday, but because of the weather, you know that we're going to make this due for
Monday
now. Okay? Got it? All right. You guys enjoy the day. Have a good day.
Carson, do we have track tonight?
Yeah.
Good.
3:15 to 4:30.
All right.
Are you coming?
Yeah.
You'll be doing hurdles mostly tonight.
All right, good deal.
Sound good?
Yep.
Thanks, Green. I'll take it right away.
Oh.
Thank you. Have a good day. you know it's fourth hour, right? Okay, you all right?